Hello and welcome to High Caliber TV, your source for figure and model updates every Wednesday and Friday. So this is sort of a one-off video. I'm going to call it a mishap Monday because the reason why I didn't really have anything to show on Wednesday with the Rook build is because I've been wrestling with this airbrush for about 2 weeks now. Possibly for longer than that and I just didn't realize it, but after making the insides gleam with, you know, lacquer thinner, Windex, everything that under the sun that I could try to clean that out, I talked to Alan and he suggested that I check this, which is the front brass nozzle port. It's on the inside of the nose cone. So I checked it very closely and I'm not sure if it comes out here, but there is a very, very slight bend in the opening, the aperture here where the needle goes through. And the bend is inward, so it doesn't allow, first of all, it doesn't allow the needle to fully return home. And then once it is home-ish, it doesn't allow it to pull back. So there's constantly air exiting through the front of the nozzle. Plus, the air doesn't get a chance from the compressor to fully eject through the front. And so that didn't allow really any paint to be sprayed out. So I went out to my local shop and got a replacement, which was easy enough. It's just a direct replacement and you have to take this out every time you clean it anyway, so the replacing of it wasn't the problem. It was just the knowledge that this was my error. So with the new one in place, everything works so well. It really makes me wonder how long this has been even a minor problem, and I've only been exacerbating it possibly by constantly pushing the needle in and drawing it back rapidly. I think the reason why this happened was because it was dropped at some point. I don't remember dropping it, but it probably happened. And then a very small sort of break and dent was made here. And then that's been exacerbated over time, which has led it to be nigh on useless, actually. I'm thinking about just getting rid of this piece because I can't even use it as a replacement. So production on the Rook continues. The thing, like I said, tomorrow's video, I'll be showing off what I've been able to do. I've been able to cover so much ground recently, so rapidly with the Rook because of how well the replacement bit works. And it's really just such a joy. It's a crazy feeling of accomplishment, which might not be the right word, but when you get the airbrush to actually work properly and it works like the machine that it is and it performs its function as it's supposed to, because like I don't have a problem keeping the internals clean after every work, but this malfunction here, the physical malfunction, has made the airbrush, like I said, nearly useless for the past couple of weeks. So yeah, thanks very much for checking out this little rant. If you've got any horror stories or tips about airbrush cleaning and maintenance, leave it in the comments below. Thanks very much for everyone who's contacted me about their current builds and stuff like that. Apparently I've inspired some people to take their Abrams out of their shelves of shame or to start on their builds, and that feels really good. I really appreciate everybody who's contacted me about that. I think that's really, really cool. And you know, keep up the good work. The people who've sent me photos, it's really, really cool, the stuff that they're doing with their vehicles and with their kits. So yeah, so keep it up, and I'll see you next time. Bye.